Hello everyone, welcome to Join to Lunch Channel. So in this video we are going to cover the topic name as rank of the matrix, which is very important topic. I said in the previous video as well. So in this topic you can surely expect one essay question. So when it comes to rank of the matrix, we have two ways of finding the rank of the matrix. So what are those two ways? The first way is using normal form. So whatever it is in your syllabus, I'll be discussing only those ways. The extra ones are not necessary. The aim is to find the rank, so you can use any method. Okay, I'll tell you the very simple one also, a shortcut method, so you can use that method for verifying. As I already discussed in the previous videos, that shortcuts are only used for verifying when it comes to SEM exams. Okay, the first method is normal form or canonical form, and the second one is row echelon form. These two are the methods we have for finding the rank of the matrix. So before going into these two methods, what is meant by rank? So this is our first question, which has to be raised inside your minds. Okay, what is rank? So what is rank means? So I am telling you the shortcut as well in the definition itself. If in a matrix the highest order minor whose value is not equal to 0, the order of that minor is a rank. Okay, now what is the thing which you got here? Minor. Okay, we already saw what is meant by minor. So minor is nothing but when you consider any element by removing the row in which that element is present and column in which that present element is present, with the remaining elements you will be getting a matrix. Determinant of that matrix is known as minor. So I am simply dictating you this definition because I already discussed in very detail in the previous videos. So my sincere request is, if someone is coming directly to this video, don't watch like this. Without watching previous videos, you won't understand my present video. So watch each and every video of the playlist, then come to this video. Okay, you already know what is meant by rank, minor. So what is the rank means? So in a matrix, the highest order minor whose value is not equal to 0, order of that minor is rank. Okay, so I am going to explain you. Okay, let me write down the definition for you. In a matrix, highest minor whose value is not equal to 0, then order of that minor is rank. Let me explain you this definition. Yeah, I know most of you people have got confused, and you must have also what is this fellow teaching, we are not getting anything like this. Your thoughts would have started, but let me explain you with the example, then you will come to know, you will get some clarity. Okay. Okay, I'm changing the color. I am taking one matrix A whose values are, so I have taken a matrix whose values are 1 2 3 2 0 5 minus 1 3 1. The aim is to find the rank of this matrix. So after rowing this normal form or row echelon form, you can find using these two methods. But before that, know this shortcut. Okay, this is shortcut, very simple method for finding out the rank. Okay, so what you have to do now, as I already discussed in the definition, what is a rank? The highest minor whose value not equals to 0. So what is the highest minor in this matrix? You people have to answer me. So what is a minor? You already know. So now the question is, these kind of questions you have to answer, then only I'll come to know that you people have understood the concept clearly, or else there is no point of explaining you in this much detail. Okay, I am explaining you each and everything which is not in your syllabus also with clear explanation, because you have to you have to understand the feeling of the subject. That is the important thing, okay? So now tell me, what is the minor of this matrix? Minor nothing but a determinant. So what is the highest determinant which you can find out from this matrix? Yeah, okay, I'm explaining you. So this is the highest minor we have. What is that? 1, 2, 3, 2, 0, 5, minus 1, 3, 1, right? You have to find out this determinant. If this value is not equal to 0, then the order of this highest minor is rank. So some people must have got like, bro, you already told that minor is obtained by deleting some rows and columns, right? Now you did not delete any rows and columns. How can you say this thing as a minor? So if you people have got that doubt, then you are on the right track, okay? You are understanding the subject. See, that is true that I told you that by deleting some rows and columns, the remaining elements which are formed, the matrix which is formed by the remaining elements, determinant of that particular matrix is minor. Now here, when it comes to this part, I have deleted 0 rows and 0 columns. What's wrong in that? I can also delete 0 rows and 0 columns. So that is also nothing but deleting some rows and columns. So 0 rows and 0 columns I deleted. So then I got this matrix itself. So this is the highest minor. You have to remember this point. Whenever you have 4x4 matrix, in that also the highest minor is that 4x4 matrix itself. So that is how this thing has become a minor. So now find out this determinant. You already know the shortcut for finding out the determinant, right? I discussed with you. 1, 2, -2, 0, 3, 3, 5, 1. Again, I am saying you, if someone is watching this video without watching the previous videos, you won't get these shortcuts and all. One moment. See, 1, 2, -1, 2, 0, 3, 3, 5, 1. Again, you have to write the first row, first column. 2, 0, 3. Now what you have to do, you have to simply multiply 1 × 0 × 1 + 2 × 5 × -1. These things I'm multiplying. I already discussed. There is no need of discussing. Still, I'll discuss. 3, 2, 3. Okay, minus of what is this? -1 × 0 × 3. Then +3 × 5 × 1 + 1 × 2 × 2, right? 1 × 2 × 2. Now what you will get here, the first value is 0, this is -10, this is +18. -10 + 18 minus of what is this? 0 + 15 + 4 this is 19. Okay, here what is this? This is +8 - 19, right? This is nothing but -7, right? Or -11. Okay, so whatever the value we got, this is not equal to 0. So then according to the definition, the highest minor value is not equal to 0, then the order of that minor is rank, we said. So what is the order of this one? It is a 3x3 matrix, so order is 3. So rank of this matrix, rank of A, rank we do not with this row. So rank of A is equal to 3. So this is the shortcut for finding out the rank. Now let us see what is meant by normal form. The normal form is very important for your sem examination. So listen carefully. You have some steps which you have to follow. Normal form, okay. So the first step which you have to do is, first of all, how these normal forms will look is, you have three normal forms, and you have to convert the given matrix in one of these three forms, then you can conclude the, then you can find out the rank of the matrix. If you are given some A matrix, then you have to convert it as IR000 or IR0 or IR0. These are three normal forms. After the main motto of finding out the rank in normal form is, you have to convert the given matrix in one of these three forms. After converting in these forms, You are getting some identity matrix here, right? So what is R? R is nothing but the order of that identity matrix. This order of identity matrix is also known as rank of the matrix. Rank of the matrix. This is our normal form. Very easy. You have to know how to convert in these three forms. So you have some steps for converting any given matrix in these forms. So in those steps, the first one is step one. Let us consider you are given a matrix A. A11, A12, A13. Next B11, B12, B13. Next C11, C12, C13. This is the matrix which you are given. This is a 3x3 matrix. So first of all, what you have to do is step two. You write in this way. Your notes must be in this way. For the first time, I am explaining you by writing in a proper manner so that you will come to know how to prepare the notes. In the first, in the second step, what you have to do is you have to make A11 is equals to 1 by elementary transformations. You already know what is meant by elementary transformation. This is our first step. And this is our second step. Step 3. Actually, this is our first step only. In the first step, I wrote the given matrix. Step 3 is you have to make these elements. And it means the elements which are below A11 and the elements which are beside A11 as zeros. So, elements below and beside A11 must become zero. Okay, what is step 4? The step 4 is again make. You have to focus on the diagonal element. Since the thing is you have to convert into the identity matrix, then you have to focus on the diagonal elements. Make B12 is equals to 1 by elementary transformations. In the step 5, the same thing applies here also. You have to make below and beside elements of B11, below and beside elements of B11 must equals to 0. This is our fifth step. What is our sixth step? Step 6 is make C13 is equals to 1 by elementary transformation. If you had any elements below and beside this C13, then you have to make those elements as 0 in next step. This is the process of finding out the rank using normal form. So when you follow these steps carefully, then you can see that the given matrix will be converted into one of the above three forms. Then you can simply conclude that the order of the identity matrix is rank of the matrix. Now the important thing which you have to note down is, so for making the below elements 0, you have to use row operations only. Row operations. You can also include this thing as another step. Okay, now the thing is you have to write as many steps as possible in your examination. So the presentation must be very neat, very well. So then only you'll get full marks. Then the beside elements have to be made 0 by using column operations only. You can't do row operations for that. Okay, this is important thing to be noted. So this is known as normal form. I clearly understand that many people would not have understood anything till now. Not many people, but some of the people might not have understood anything till now. But some people would have got a clear cut idea on what has been discussed. Okay, for the people who already got the idea and the people who are still having some confusions and the people who did not understand a single thing also, For all these three categories, I am going to explain this normal form with the previous example, which will find out the rank using the shortcut. So this thing I am going to take and I am going to explain using normal form. Then each and everyone will be able to understand what is meant by normal form. So example, A is equals to, what is given, 1, 2, 3, sorry, 205 minus 1, 3, 1, 205 minus 1, 3, 1. So, find out the rank of matrix using normal form. This is the question you will be asked in your exam. So, what you have to do, first step is make A11 as 1. A11 as 1, though, so coincidentally you already got the A11 as 1. So the next step which you have to do is below elements and beside elements have to be 0. For the below elements, you have to do elementary transformations. Now I am doing that. So in the first step, I am doing R2 implies R2 minus 2R1. Okay, R2 implies R2 minus 2R1. Then R3 implies R3 plus R1. So after doing this transformation, what will I get? What the A will be transformed into? 1, 2, 3. Next, R2 implies R2 minus 2R1. So 2 minus 2 into 1. So 2 minus 2, 0. 0 minus 2 into 4, right? 0 minus, yeah, minus 4 this is. 5 minus 6, minus 1 this is. Now R3 plus R1, R3 implies. So R3 will be changed as R3 plus R1, minus 1 plus 1, 0, then 3 plus 2, 5, then 1 plus 3, 4. Now this is what I got. I am simply multiplying R2 with minus 1 into R2. Simply I am doing for removing the minus sign. So I will get plus 4 plus 1 after this step. Now what I have to do is, I have to make these two elements as 0. For this, I told already that you have to use only column operations. The column operations are C2 implies C2 minus 2C1 and C3 implies C3 minus 3C1. So what you will get after these two column operations? So you are going to get 100. You have C2 implies C2 minus 2C1. C2 minus 2C1. So 2 minus 2, 0. 4 minus 2 into 0, 4. 5 minus 0, 5. C3 minus 3C1, 3 minus 3, 0. 1 minus 3 into 0, 1. So 4 minus 3 into 0, 4. Okay. Now the second aim is, you have to make this element as 1. So I am doing R2 implies R2 by 4, right? R2 implies R2 by 4. Then what you will get, what this will be transformed into? 1 0 0 0 1 1 by 4 0 5 4. So next, the aim is, you have to make the below as well as the side elements as 0. For that, I am doing operations as R3 implies R3 minus 5 R1, right? R3 minus 5 R1. By this, I can make this thing as 0. Let us do that. 1 0 0 0 1 1 by 4. Now R3 minus 5 R1, I said 0 minus, sorry, R3 minus 5 R2 this is, because you cannot disturb this one, right? If you do R3 minus 5 R1, this will get disturbed. 0 minus 5, again this will become minus 5, again you have to do this 0. So when it 0 minus 0 is will also become 0, that is why I'll use this thing R2. This is how you have to use your brain, okay? But simply you have to do row operation does not indicate that you can again disturb this element. You have to do row operation in such a way that nothing of the format is going to get changed. Okay, that is why I am doing R3 minus 5 R2. 0 minus 5 into 0, 0 again. 5 minus 5 into 1, what is this? 5 minus 5, 0. 4 minus 5 into 1 by 4. So 4 minus 5 by 4, what will it become? 11 by 4 it becomes. Okay, now what is your aim? I guess you have to make this thing as 0. For this, you have to use column operations. What I will do is, C3 implies 4C3 minus C2 I'll do, right? So what this matrix will get transformed into 1 0 0 0 1 0. Now what will it become? C4 C3 4 into 0 minus C2 minus 0 0 minus 0 0 4C3 4 into 1 by 4 it is 1 minus C2 minus 1. So 4 1 minus 1 0 4C3 4 into 11 by 4 4 11 it becomes minus C2 minus 0. So here it is 11. Now what is your aim? You have to make this element as 1. So what for this, what I will do? C3 implies C3 by 11. So I will get this as 1 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 11 by 11 1. So I can write this matrix as, either I will write this matrix 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Here I will write zeros, nothing is going to get changed simply if I write zeros here. Or I can also write this matrix as 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0. I'll write in this way also. The same matrix I can also write like this. So if I write like this, that this is like I3 comma 0, not comma I3 0. So this is one of the form. If I write this matrix like this, then it is nothing but I3 0. Why I am writing 3? Because the order of the identity matrix which we got is 3 by 3. So I3 0. So now you have got, you converted the given matrix in one of the normal form using the same steps which I explained. So the rank is nothing but order of identity matrix. What is that? 3. So here we can simply say that rank of A is equals to 3. This is our normal form. So this is how you have to do. Simply, if you clearly write this these steps one by one in your exam, if you present them neatly, then you'll get full marks for this question. So now the thing is, normal form is not only discussed for square matrices, it is also discussed for rectangular matrices, which we are going to cover in the next video. Till now, if you people have any doubts, please let me know in the comment section. I'll be seeing your comments. Thank you for watching. We'll catch up in the next video.